Hey folks, this is BestInSlot. Welcome back to our coverage of the Camp Cretaceous Pack and indeed Update 2 for Jurassic World Evolution 2. In this video, we're going to focus on the free update. This is the content that every single one of you with the game will get for free when you update your game later on today. And there's a lot of cool stuff. I've picked out the most important stuff. Let's check it out. We're really going to be focusing on a sandbox today. First things first, all your dinosaur skins and stuff will be available in sandbox right from the get-go. You don't need to unlock any dinosaurs. That includes the new Camp Cretaceous dinosaurs. And you don't need to unlock any skins via the campaign and stuff like that, other than the challenge mode skins. You will still need to unlock those if you want to use those. Everything else will be unlocked. The main change in sandbox mode is a few new toggles. If we go down here to sandbox settings and scroll down, you'll see here at the bottom we've got scientists and tasks. Scientists can now be turned off and on as you choose, and then they're unrest, as you can see, like in the past. We're gonna keep those off. I'll show you how that works in just a moment. You can now turn expeditions and fossils on for your sandbox mode. So if you wanted to start sending out dig teams, if you wanted to limit yourself at the start and have a more JPOG style experience, but in sandbox, you can now do that. Research, same deal, so it's expeditions and research are separate. And task time, so this is for things like research, things like incubation. Again, I'll show you that in just a second. But you can set various different numbers for this, 100, 75, 50, 25, and 10. And it doesn't include building buildings, but it includes a lot of other things. So we've got research, expeditions, fossil extraction, synthesis, incubation, paleomedical treatment, and resting tasks. So with those settings on, if I actually hit the apply button, lovely stuff. Yeah, okay, let's just hop into our game. If we go down here to a hatchery, and we're going to click synthesize dinosaur. Well, big dinosaurs, let's go for an acrocanthosaurus right there. Begin task, you'll see I didn't need to click a scientist, I didn't need to do that. All you do is click the begin task button. And you'll see here, based on the time limit, this is still, you have to wait a little bit, you know, but it's 11, 12 seconds rather than 100 seconds, so you know, a couple of minutes, which is what it would have been in the past. Select your eggs as per usual, and again, begin task, and it gets going. And if you speed up your time like so, your tasks, they take a little bit of time, but on 10%, of course, it is a whole lot quicker. This is a really, really positive change, one that we've been wanting for a little while. I wish it applied to making buildings as well, but honestly, that is small potatoes compared to everything else going on. Teeny tiny baby potatoes. So, lots of other things to check out. Let's take a look at the new decorations. We've got a couple of new signs over here. We've got one for the Pteranodon and one for the Mosasaurus. Both are new and original. We've got like a unique sort of post here and some cool new designs. Pteranodon in particular, very dramatic. And down here, we've got the classic Jurassic Park ones as well. Jurassic World, I should say, if you want to highlight your aviary, gyrosphere, Jurassic Tour, or Lagoon. Again, these look really nice. Again, this one, I think the gyrosphere in particular feels ripped straight from the film, which is pretty sweet for all of us who've been trying to build, say, accurate Jurassic World representations. Over here, we have our new foliage options. I'm going to show you the tropical set. There is a different set of placeable trees, depending on if you are in tropical or alpine or whatever different biome you're building in. And I'm just going to show you this in the menu for a second because it's a little odd. So if we go into the correct button and we hit this one right here, you'll see you've got now different groups of trees. So we've got large tree, that's our big chunky boy there. We've then got medium tree, making sense so far. And then we've got small tree, makes sense. But then we've also got bushy tree. Now bushy trees, interestingly enough, are largely not trees. I don't know why they're called bushy trees and not, you know, bushes or plants or whatever. But there you go, you've got a host of individual placeable foliage, and for tropical, your selection looks something like this. But then we've also got a couple of new planters. We've got this wibbly wobbly one over here. I love a good wibble wobble, so that's really cool. We've got some wooden ones over here as well, with some gravel in the top, and this one there. Those two aren't new, of course. This tree one here, this single planter there, and these square ones over here. So a lot more variety this time in planter shape, a lot more creative control. We can squeeze them into various different gaps. And the cool thing is really that these are sort of squarer in shape, and these ones and these ones and these ones, because the original ones over here, as you can see, they're kind of wibbly bendy. I'm saying wibbly far too many times today. They're very wibbly though. And that can make them a little difficult to fit in certain locations. And we'd often use these to kind of like hem in a path, and it looked okay, but I think it's going to look a lot better with ones like this. Many more decorations still to go though. So we've got our general sort of park decorations over here. If we swing around to this left-hand side, we've got poles, and we've got poles with a thing. I think it's meant to be like a sunshade. And this very cool, unexpected, pteranodon statue sort of thing. This is really the kind of thing we'd get in a Planet Zoo DLC, and I think it's the kind of thing we've been crying out for, really, to decorate our parks even more than we've been able to. So really cool that we're getting all this stuff. And this was a surprise. I didn't see this before, but this is like a it's like part of the Jurassic Park tower, so you could have your Jurassic Park gates at the entrance and then have these little ones spread around and kind of hemming in these new areas. I think those are going to look really cool when used. Am I still in speedy time? I am still in speedy time. We've also got some new fountains. So we've got some little baby fountains, with lovely glistening water falling down onto the rocks. We've got this one back in their funky wibbly wobbly shape, spraying up like so. And then we've got these big boys over here. This one with this sort of rusted metal bronze DNA symbol in the middle. Very cool. And then this lovely one over here with a big old rock, some amber, some plants and stuff like that. I'll showcase you all of these at nighttime in just a moment because they are worth seeing. Finally then, for this set of decorations, no, we're not done yet. We've got these amber with this lovely sort of sheer effect. It's quite brown. It's not very bright and orangey, but it does get that kind of effect in the right lighting. And we've got a little one, circle one of those, and we've got, again, another wibbly-wobbly sort of rectangular one over there. So you've got three different flavours depending on how big the gap is you're trying to fill. And then finally, we've got this bad boy over here. What an absolute beauty she is. Of course, taken straight from Jurassic World itself, and clearly the inspiration for where we ended up with these other pole designs is the Spinosaurus skeleton. Doesn't she look fantastic? I'm giving you a dramatic shot of all the way around. Do, 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 do. Now, all we need is the capability for our Indominus Rex to smash through it. Or of T-Rex, I actually don't remember. Either way, very, very cool. Love seeing this, really well designed. Kind of want more skeletons, if nothing else. I think that's very, very high in my future list now. Yeah, looks fantastic. And we're not even done with the decorations. Honestly, the biggest part of this update. There are tons of bloody things. We're trying to be a little snappy here. We've got a cage here. We've got a couple of aviary stands, aviary perches. These do work with your Pteranodons, your Pterosaurs in general. I'll showcase that in the aviary in just a moment. Down here, we've got a camera pole, like a security camera sort of thing. A little concrete barrier. We've got a crane for some reason. I love it. The crane is my favourite. We've got a classic Jurassic Park style cage, like the raptor at the start of the film there. We've got like this little generator shed thing. We've got, of course, the return of the raptor pen from the first film and from the first game as well. We've got this trailer thingamajiggy sort of thing over here. It is just a sort of a trailer office. We've got a tent with some utility objects in there. We've got another tent over here as well. I think there's a third tent. Let me zoom up a little bit. There is not. Oh, there's sort of this thing over here, like a utility tent, little shipping container mix kind of thing. You see, they're all DFW themed. It's meant to be more utilitarian themed buildings. We've got a gas canister over there. We've got very cool, the giant cage structure they used to capture the Tyrannosaurus Rex at the end of the Lost World Jurassic Park. I think that is such an awesome, unexpected addition. I really like that. We've got a big old wooden box. We've got a few shipping crates over here. We've got a blue one, we've got a white one, we've got a green one with a little DFW. I just love those little details. This isn't DFW, this is US Fish and Wildlife. Little crate thing over there, little crate thing over there with some barrels, and a crate shed thing over there. I think that's it, finally. Yes, so tons of decorations there. They all laid out for you. Those are just the new ones. So of course you still have all the ones that we used to have in the past. And of course there's different placeable trees depending on the biome and stuff like that as well. So just for free players, for those of us who don't buy the DLC, and those of you at home who choose not to buy the DLC, you are still getting a ton of content here, which is pretty awesome. Let's go check out that aviary. Hopefully someone is sitting on the ledge right now. Yep, there you go. And you can see them there on the tall one that's two-tiered, and you can place it in the water, so if they want to sit above the water like so, they can do that as well, which is pretty cool. There you go. I know people like to take screenshots and stuff for posts, so I'll try to get some good looks at this kind of stuff. There you go, lovely stuff. And better look at the double one right there. Yeah, really good. I love that this is in the game. What I really want next is like a rocky version of this, but this is a fantastic addition, something again we've wanted for a long time, so really happy this is part of the free update as well, so everyone at home gets to play with this, because it's pretty cool. Gonna make our aviaries more exciting. Right, that's it for new items, finally. There's still a few more things to go. We've got a first-person viewer. You can see it's down here now in this new button, just above the delete button. First-person view, and then you kind of just click where you want to go. So if I want to drop here, boop, I'm now in first-person mode. I can shift for speed. I can hold control to crouch. I can hide the UI like so. I can even open my map while I'm here. Look at that, isn't that good? Like a little RPG first-person kind of game. That's pretty sweet. And you can even interact with buildings whilst you're doing this. So you can open the building menu here if you want to edit your restroom. So you can manage your park from this first-person point of view. If you want to open the hatchery, you can do that right here and actually synthesize your pterosaurs from right here. And then when I... Okay, that actually broke it. But I think that should work in theory. And you can do most of the things like this. You can manage a lot of your park just from the first person point of view, which is obviously pretty bloody awesome. Again, a thing I've really wanted for a long time. I cannot wait to make a Jurassic World horror experience, because if you make it not nighttime, not only is it super cool looking and dramatic, and like I said, I'll show you these fountains and stuff at nighttime as well. Man, not only does it look really cool, but we have a flashlight. Not only just a light, but a directional flashlight. So it kind of feels like you're playing Slender Man. And I really, really approve of that. I think it's really cool. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to the idea of building like a horror experience in the game. I'll quickly show you those decorations as mentioned. Where are we? Where do we live? We live over here. Because there's some lights on these. That's got some lights on as well, which I didn't know about. That's got some lights. The tent over there is lit up a little bit as well. And a few lights on the crane over there. And of course the raptor paddock. Little holding pen, we'll call it, because that's really what it is. Even the plant swaying in there. Little suggestion that maybe there's something rumbling around inside. But of course, what I really wanted to show you was over here. So all the fountains light up, as you can see. Let's get in there a little bit. JK. It looks beautiful, actually. It's really nice stuff. They all light up like so. And all your ambers light up. And your skeleton lights up. Look at it. Your skeleton lights up. And of course, the Jurassic Park barrier pole thing also lights up. Let's swap it back to daytime. We are nearly done, but not done. Not quite yet. There's a couple of other generally cool changes I want to show you. One in particular, which is now if you go to a ranger post like so, you can actually assign your MVU team. It'll tell you how far away that facility is. And now your MVU teams will start to do a circular, they'll start to drive around, they'll start to do the rotation. And if a dinosaur needs curing, they'll hook it up, they'll source it out. So no longer do you have to continuously ship your dinosaurs back and forth, or keep sending your teams out. You can now have a vet unit that's maybe dedicated to this kind of thing. So that's a really cool change for a challenge mode in particular, I would suggest. And as well, if we go over here to the tour, now of course this is only for the Jurassic tour, or probably the gyrosphere, not the Jurassic Park tour, but there's a new gate, as you can see. It's very, very similar to the existing gate. They've simply swapped the Jurassic Park logo with the Jurassic World logo, but it's more appropriate thematically, and really not a change I think they had to do by any stretch of the imagination. So I love that kind of thing. You know, something where nobody was really asking for it, per se, as far as I've seen, anyway, but it's just a cool change. It's a positive change, so there you go. The last thing to show you then is the brand new species viewer. So let's check that out. It is here on the main page up here at the top, as you can see. Click that button. There's a random velociraptor there. Enter species viewer. It is a shame we can't access this from in-game, as far as I can tell. That would obviously be a big positive, because people want to use this mainly as a kind of skin preview sort of thing. Press H to hide the UI, very cool. And if we pick a dinosaur, you're gonna have to check out the other videos for the Scorpios Rex, I'm afraid. Let's say Ceratosaurus, why not? There you go. And you can change the skin color like so. Preview, oh, that looks awesome. Preview all the different skin colors, all the different patterns as you want. And what you could just do is make a sort of little list of what you want that dinosaur to be and then go and make it in-game. It's a little bit finicky, but it's obviously a humongous improvement on what we already had. So you've picked out your Carnotaurus, I should say. There we go, looking lovely. You can pause if you want it to look sleepy for some reason. You know, who doesn't? And if you go into here, we can also pick some animations. So we've got a walking animation, we've got a running animation, we've got a sitting down sort of resting. It's adorable animation. We've got a sort of nuzzling the ground custom animation there, and then we've got its idle standing animation as well, where it kind of just looks around and sniffs and does Ceratosaurus things. More than that though, we're not done quite yet. You can go ahead and you can click this button here. You can change the color grading, Jurassic World, Jurassic World Neutral, Jurassic World Alpine, and Jurassic Park. Oh, they all look so different actually. I like neutral, let's go neutral. And you can change the position of the light like so. You can then rotate that light however you want as well around the dinosaur if you want to get like a dramatic backlit effect like that. And you can even change the height of it. So if you want to light it from underneath or from above and stuff like that. You've got tons of options basically to make this look however you want. It's a really inclusive, really well-designed species viewer. Hopefully we get the ability to put it into the game eventually. That would be awesome, but it's still a big step in the right direction. And also, how do I do this? It's because I got voice volume off. Bear with me. That's my bad. That's just me being stupid.
Ceratosaurus.
Yeah.
Ceratosaurus.
Ceratosaurus. Okay, yeah, very cool. Let me just hear another one.
Attenborosaurus.
And it does. I don't know if it's on purpose. It must be on purpose. It does sound like Richard Kiley from the first Jurassic Park, which is a pretty cool little addition. So that is it, ladies and gentlemen. That is the free update. There are some other things in there, but like smaller changes. This is definitely the big stuff you'll be excited about. All skins and dinosaurs available from the start over in the challenge mode ones, new research mechanics for sandbox, task time length is a big deal, and of course no scientists, huge deal. Decorations and trees, first person view, species viewer, assigned MVUs to ranger posts, and the Jurassic World tour gate thrown in there at the end as well. Okay, cool. Thank you so much for joining me. I think this might be the last video. I don't know. This is the first one I've recorded, so it's very complicated for me. Either way, thank you so much for joining me for today. Obviously, subscribe to the channel for lots more Jurassic World Evolution 2 content and more content and update too. We're going to do an unmodded horror-themed park. It's going to be very, very cool. And I think that's about it for me. So thank you so much for joining me. Throw me a like if you enjoyed the video. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Oh, and let me know which part of this update you're most excited about. Yeah, cool. Bye-bye. Reaching out.